Cheers! This is Jan with Workflow Engine. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple task management workflow. If you're not familiar with the interface of the Visual Designer, have a look at our previous video. Say we want to create a workflow where we would be able to put a new task to our backlog, mark it as being executed when we start working on it, submit the task for review, and mark it as completed if the review was successful. Also, let's add an option to reject execution of a task and remove it from the backlog, and an option to send the task back from review if not done properly. Before we proceed, it's important that you understand the difference between states and activities. Activities in Workflow Engine are essentially the steps of your workflow, whereas states are major stages of your business process. One state might have many activities that belong to it. In our scenario, we will have the following states: backlog, in progress, and completed. The backlog state will have the to-do activity, the in progress state will have the being done and under review activities, and the completed state will have the done and won't do activities. Let's start with a blank canvas and create an activity by clicking the Create Activity button. Add four more activities the same way and spread them over the canvas for better readability. Now let's set up our activities. To do that, you need to bring up the settings of each activity by double-clicking on it. The settings here are as follows. Name represents the name of your activity. State represents the name of the state that this activity belongs to. The initial checkbox marks whether this is the activity your workflow should start with. You can have only one initial activity. The initial activity is always painted green. The final checkbox marks whether this is the activity your workflow should end with. You can have multiple or no final activities in your workflow. The final activity is always painted blue. The for set state checkbox marks whether this should be the initial activity for a certain state when you programmatically set your process into it. We will leave the rest of the settings for now. They represent more complex scenarios and will be covered in the upcoming videos. Let's call the first activity to do, specify backlog as the state, and set this activity as initial, as this will be the activity we start our workflow with. Let's call the second activity being done, specify in progress as the state, and set this activity as initial for this state by ticking the for set state checkbox. Let's call the third activity under review and specify in progress as the state. Let's call the fourth activity done, specify completed as the state, and mark it as a final one. Let's call the fifth activity won't do, specify completed as the state, and mark it as a final one. Ultimately, we end up having three states of our business process: backlog, in progress, and completed, with each having one or more activities in it. Let's connect our activities to one another to finalize our workflow. Activities are connected with one another with transitions. In order to create a transition, you need to select the activity you want to transition from, click on the arrow icon, and click on the activity you want to transition to. Let's make a linear workflow from to do through being done and under review to done. Let's add another transition from under review to being done for cases where the task needs to be sent back from review to be improved, and a transition from to do to won't do for cases when the task is rejected. Now we need to set up our transitions. To do that, double-click a transition to bring up its settings. The settings here are as follows. Name represents the name of your activity. Classifier represents the direction of your transition. It can be direct, reverse, or unspecified. Trigger specifies when the transition should be executed. There are three trigger options. Auto, the transition will be executed immediately if the process reaches the activity the transition stems from. Command, the transition will be executed upon the receipt of a command from an external source by the workflow engine. Timer, the transition will be executed on a specified time or date, or upon expiry of a specified period of time. We will leave the rest of the settings for now. They represent more complex scenarios and will be covered in the upcoming videos. Let's set all transition classifiers to direct, except for the one which sends the task back from under review to being done. For the purposes of this tutorial, we will assume that all transitions shall be executed with a command. Hence, we need to specify five commands for our five transitions. To do that, click the Commands button and create five commands called Start Progress, Start Review, Complete Review, Send Back, and Reject Task. Now, double-click each transition, specify command as the trigger, and select the respective command that will launch each transition. Start Progress for the transition from to do to being done, Start Review for the transition from being done to under review, Complete Review for the transition from under review to done, send back for the transition from under review back to being done, and reject task for the transition from to do to won't do. We've successfully created a simple task management workflow with a visual designer. Stay tuned for our next video, where we'll create a more complicated workflow and dive deeper into transition conditions.